Good evening and welcome to King of Glory for our Lenten service tonight. And also I want to specially greet congregation, and because I know you're all want to tell me welcome back from Israel. And I'm still feeling the jet lag, but there will be a time and place where I will share pictures and stories. So you can rest assured that's coming, and that will come out. And so your questions to hear more will come. So, but tonight we are kind of doing, we're repeating, since Ash Wednesday was canceled for the snowstorm, so we're keeping that order for tonight. I'm not going to call it Ash Wednesday, but we're going to do the same thing. We're still starting off Lent, and Lent has a great history to it and a great purpose to it, as a time set aside to reflect on our lives, to reflect on God's word, and let God's word speak to us, reveal to us things we need to repent of, to turn away from, and how we need to turn back to God, turn towards his holy ways. And it's also often a time of giving up things. I think we often associate with Lent as a time of giving up something, as a form of fasting. And fasting has a spiritual benefit to it, because when we fast, when we give up something that we love or give up something we're very used to, the purpose of that is to remind ourselves that what I truly need is God. I can give up these other things. And sometimes it's good to actually go through the act of giving up something for a while. And the purpose is not to show how sacrificial I am. The purpose is to remind myself, oh man, it is hard to give this up, but what I truly need is God. And I can give this up. I can go without these things because God is sufficient and he is good. And so so Lent here has, you know, so I'm not going to tell you what you should or must absolutely do during Lent, but I will encourage you as you read scripture, as you hear these things, to think about God is when it's let his word speak to you. If it's telling you to wake up, if it reveals something that you need to repent of and to rethink in your life, then follow that, listen to that, lean into that, pray to God about that and what he would have you do about it. And when he makes it clear with his word, well, follow him and do it. And so tonight's service, then, I'm not going to have a message or a sermon in it anywhere. We're going to have I've selected four scripture readings, and these scriptures deal with repentance, but they also deal with that. So they deal with that turning away. They also deal with that new life, turning to. What is the new life in God we are to turn to? And also, how do we do that humbly? Without self-righteous arrogance. And so as we read these verses, I'm going to read them all, and we'll read them kind of slowly here so you can hear them, reflect on them, and really let the words, try to let them sink in. Ask the Holy Spirit to help you have a receptive heart to hear them, receive them. And then as we sing the songs too, let your heart and mind sing them. Or just sit and listen to, if that's what you need, to listen to the song being sung. And so we're going to have that time of reflection and confession, repentance, as a way to start the whole Lenten season leading to Easter here. So with that, I'll open us in prayer and then our first scripture reading. Lord, thank you that you love us and seek us out, and you are always calling out to us, calling us to turn to you and to examine ourselves in light of your holy word and your righteousness, and to turn from our ways and turn back to you. And that you're always calling out to us, inviting us, offering us your grace and your love and your steadfast loving kindness in our lives. And pray as we hear these words, let the truth speak to us, and we respond as your Spirit leads us. Pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. So our first reading is from the prophet Joel, chapter 2, verses 12 through 19. Yet even now, declares the Lord, return to me with all your heart, with fasting, with weeping, and with mourning, and rend your hearts and not your garments. Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love. And he relents over disaster. Who knows whether he will not turn and relent and leave a blessing behind him, a grain offering and a drink offering for the Lord your God. Blow the trumpet in Zion. Consecrate a fast. Call a solemn assembly. Gather the people. Consecrate the congregation. Assemble the elders. Gather the children, even nursing infants. Let the bridegroom leave his room and the bride her chamber. Between the vestibule and the altar, let the priests, the ministers of the Lord, weep and say, spare your people, O Lord, and make not your heritage a reproach, a byword among the nations. Why should they say among the peoples, where is their God? Then the Lord became jealous for his land and had pity on his people. The Lord answered and said to his people, behold, I am sending to you grain, wine, and oil, and you will be satisfied, and I will no more make you a reproach among the nations. And maybe a verse here and there stood out to you, and for me, said, let the bridegroom leave his room and the bride her chamber. And I think of before the wedding, when the groom and the groomsmen are all in their part before the ceremony, preparing their suits and ties, and the bride and her bridesmaids are in their room, making sure everything's fixed just perfectly. And this verse just interrupts that. It says, this is how important it is to consecrate yourselves to God, to turn back, to turn to him. He says, bridegroom, leave. Go to the altar and seek out God. Bride, leave. Go to the altar, seek out God. That's how seriously God takes the call to repentance and turning back to him. This should even interrupt your wedding, which is, I can't imagine that. Can't imagine something coming through on my, as I'm preparing for the wedding day and saying, oh, no, I have to drop everything and I have to go get right with God. But that's what his word says. And so our appropriate response here with that is our own confession of sin, to get right with God. And it's printed in the bulletin here. But this is from page 2 in the Master Hymnal as well. And we're going to say this aloud together. It says, Almighty God, our Maker and Redeemer, we poor sinners confess to you that we are by nature sinful and unclean, that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed. Therefore, we flee for refuge to your infinite mercy and ask you for Christ's sake, grant us forgiveness of all our sins, and by your Holy Spirit, increase in us true knowledge of you and of your will and true obedience to your word, to the end that by your grace we may come to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, has had mercy upon us and has given his only Son to die for us, and for his sake forgives us all our sins. To those who believe on his name, he gives power to become sons of God and has promised them his Holy Spirit. He who believes and is baptized shall be saved. Grant this, Lord, to us all. Amen. Please turn in your hymnal to number 62, Beneath the Cross of Jesus. Our next scripture reading is from Psalm 51, verses 1 through 13. To the choir master, a psalm of David, when Nathan the prophet went to him after he had gone in to Bathsheba. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your steadfast love, according to your abundant mercy. Blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against you, you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight, so that you may be justified in your words and blameless in your judgment. Behold, I was brought forth in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Behold, you delight in truth in the inward being, and you teach me wisdom in the secret heart. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Let me hear joy and gladness. Let the bones that you have broken rejoice. Hide your face from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and uphold me with a willing spirit. Then I will teach transgressors your ways, and sinners will return to you. This time we're going to have a time of personal quiet reflection. Chris is going to play some instrumental music, and then as that's coming to a close, the choir is going to sing a song.
Thank you.
next reading is from the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 5, starting in verse 20 and continuing through chapter 6, verse 10. Therefore, we are ambassadors for Christ, God making his appeal through us. We implore you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. For our sake, he made him to be sin, who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. Working together with him, then, we appeal to you not to receive the grace of God in vain. For he says, in a favorable time I listened to you, and in a day of salvation I have helped you. Behold, now is the favorable time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. We put no obstacle in anyone's way, so that no fault may be found with our ministry. But as servants of God, we commend ourselves in every way, by great endurance, in afflictions, hardships, calamities, beatings, imprisonments, riots, labors, sleepless nights, hunger, by purity, knowledge, patience, kindness, the Holy Spirit, genuine love, by truthful speech, and the power of God, with the weapons of righteousness for the right hand and for the left, through honor and dishonor, through slander and praise, we are treated as impostors and yet true, as unknown and yet well known, as dying, and behold, we live, as punished and yet not killed, as sorrowful yet always rejoicing, as poor yet making many rich, as having nothing, yet possessing everything. Let's confess our faith together now in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty, from where he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the life everlasting. Amen. Turn in your hymns to number 71, Jesus, Keep Me Near the Cross. Thank you. Our next scripture reading is from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 6, verses 1 through 6 and 16 through 21. Beware of practicing your righteousness before other people in order to be seen by them. For then you will have no reward from your Father who is in heaven. Thus, when you give to the needy, sound no trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, that they may be praised by others. Truly I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you give to the needy, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your giving may be in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And when you pray, you must not be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and at the street corners, that they may be seen by others. Truly I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you pray, go into your room and shut the door and pray to your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And then verse 16. And when you fast, do not look gloomy like the hypocrites, for they disfigure their faces, that their fasting may be seen by others. Truly I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, anoint your head and wash your face, that your fasting may not be seen by others, but by your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. Do not lay up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust destroy and where thieves break in and steal, but lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust destroys and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. Let's pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please look in your hymnal to number 72, and let's sing together, What Wondrous Love Is This? receive the benediction from 2 Thessalonians 2, verses 16 and 17. Now may our Lord Jesus Christ himself and God our Father, who has loved us and given us eternal comfort and good hope by grace, comfort and strengthen your hearts in every good work and word. Amen. Go in peace.